The piston engine is a heat engine. Its purpose is to convert the energy released from burning fuel into mechanical energy, and by so doing, generate power that we can use. The thermal efficiency of a light aircraft piston gasoline engine may reach 30%. This means that 70% of the heat energy released by the fuel is wasted. Around 40% will leave with the exhaust gas, but 30% stays behind to raise the temperature of the engine components and the oil. If nothing was done to alleviate this situation, then several problems could occur. Engine components could start to fail structurally. The oil could break down and lose its lubricating properties. The fuel could ignite as soon as it entered the cylinder, before the spark plug fires. This is called pre-ignition. Pre-ignition causes loss of power and may exacerbate the overheating problem. The incoming mixture may get too hot, which will cause unstable combustion, usually called detonation or pinking. This too will cause loss of power and further overheating. So far, we've only considered what would happen if the engine overheated. Let's now look at the problems of overcooling. Maximum thermal efficiency is only achieved at high engine temperatures. Low engine temperature increases the viscosity, the internal friction of the oil, which will reduce the brake horsepower. To burn, the fuel must vaporize. Very low engine temperatures would prevent complete vaporization, and some of the fuel would not be burnt, reducing the power output of the engine. To work efficiently, the engine needs to be at the highest temperature consistent with safe operation. To maintain the engine temperature within a range which will satisfy its working requirements, a cooling system is required. Most light aircraft engines are air-cooled. The simplicity of the system makes it virtually maintenance-free, and it's much lighter than the alternative, the liquid cooling system. Having said that, the liquid cooling system is more efficient. It gives more precise control of engine temperature and generates less drag. Thus, it's used on high-performance engines. One of the major factors governing the efficiency of an air-cooled system is the air temperature. Although the ambient air temperature can vary widely with changes in climate and altitude, it must be borne in mind that dissipation of the heat will be more rapid as air temperature decreases. The speed of the airflow is the other major factor affecting the efficiency of the air cooling system. Uncontrolled, the speed of the airflow over the cylinders will vary with the speed of the aircraft, and therefore cause the temperature of the cylinders to fluctuate accordingly. Several methods of improving the efficiency of cooling systems can be employed. Firstly, the engine components are made of materials with a high conductivity. For instance, cylinder heads are sometimes made from aluminium alloys. The walls of the cylinders are finned to increase the cooling area. The fins are thin in section and may be extended to increase the area at local hotspots, such as the exhaust ports, in an attempt to achieve an even temperature throughout. It must not be forgotten that the oil used to lubricate the engine is also a cooling medium. The engine is streamlined by surrounding it by a cowling. This puts it within a controlled environment and also reduces the drag which it would otherwise generate. Baffles are directional air guides which direct the airflow fully around the cylinder. they must be close-fitting and are sealed against the cowling to ensure that all of the airflow is over the cylinders and that each part of the cylinder is supplied with equal amounts of cooling air. Cowl flaps and gills can be fitted to the cowlings to ensure control of the temperature. They are usually manually controlled on light aircraft, and when open, the airflow over them causes a pressure drop which accelerates the airflow within the cowlings. Prior to engine start, the air inlet and outlet to the cowlings must be checked to be clear of obstruction. The condition of baffles and cowling must be checked. The operation of the cowl flap, if fitted, must be checked. Remembering that, as well as lubricating the engine, oil plays an important part in engine cooling, check the oil contents. In high power settings with low airspeed conditions, such as occur at takeoff, the cowl flaps should be selected open to increase the flow rate over the cylinders and so increase cooling. In the climb and cruise, the cowl flaps or gills can be adjusted to maintain the engine temperature at the optimum. In descent, engine power is reduced and less heat is generated. If the aircraft is placed into a dive, this will tend to overcool the engine, and this can lead to what is known as thermal shock. Thus, the cowl flaps should be closed during descent to reduce the cooling effect. Anticipating a go-around, the cowl flaps should be opened on final approach. During ground running, engine oil temperatures and cylinder head temperatures should be closely monitored to ensure the limitations are not exceeded. Although initially after engine start the cowl flap should be closed to encourage quick engine warm-up, they should subsequently be opened to prevent overheating. During flight, if the cylinder head temperature becomes excessive, there are several methods of cooling the engine. Obviously, as has just been stated, the cowl flaps can be opened. Perhaps less obviously, the mixture can be richened. The excess fuel will evaporate and cool the charge. It's also logical to expect that a reduction in engine power will tend to lower engine temperatures, and likewise, an increase in forward speed will have the same effect.